Yeah, good morning. We are joined now by Rob Brierly, Managing Director at Fenix Resources. Rob, good morning to you. How are you doing?
Oh, very well, thank you, and thanks for having us on.
Good, glad to talk to you. Listen, half-yearly earnings out, looking very, very interesting indeed. Let's start with a quick look at the top-line numbers. Can you give us some details on those?
Yeah, we basically sold nearly 700,000 tonnes of iron ore. We're a niche producer of iron ore. We're not the largest. We produce a very small quantity, but our iron ore is heavily sought after. It's very high grade, and we've been able to tap into decent markets there or across Asia, not just in China, but you know, Indonesia, Malaysia, Japan, Vietnam, places like that as well. So the most of our customers love our ore, and we get good demand for it. And that saw our revenue up around about 116 million and our profit before tax of 20 million. And we now pay full tax. So we had 14 million net profit, which we were pretty happy about. It was a interesting half year because iron ore prices started very, very strong, but then weakened considerably in the December quarter, and we've really endured that period of time, and now coming out the other end, and we expect a very solid second half of this fiscal 22.
Yeah, the profit in particular seems to have impressed some people. How have you managed to drive that in the midst of all this volatility?
Well, I think we've just stayed fat with our mine plan, despite the iron ore price being heavily volatile. You know, we put in a hedge contract as well, so we have nearly 50% of our production hedged at high prices or higher prices, so about $230 Aussie per tonne, which is equivalent to around about 170 US. So good pricing, good price protection. We purposely put that in place so we could continue on with our mine plan and not be distracted by short-term aberrations. And that's proved quite a good strategy.
Yeah, it certainly looks to have been the case. I understand you've had some strong performances as well, though, from your Iron Ridge mine in WA. What more can you tell us about what's going on there?
Well, the grades have been a lot better than we expected. The amount of lump material, which sells at a premium to the fines, has been a lot more than we expected as well. And, you know, the efficiency of our operation, it's quite simple. It's only a small operation. There's no fancy processing. There's just crushing and screening once you dig it out of the ground. And then we have to truck it to our nearest bulk export port, which is in Geraldton, where we've got, you know, company-owned facilities down there to handle the material and get it onto a ship. So we like to think we're pretty efficient. We're certainly not the lowest cost producer, but that's because the way that we configured the operation was basically to use contractors and to keep our capital costs of starting up the operation very low. So to give you an idea, we started this whole project up with CapEx of around about $15 million, which is very, very light capital. So our operating costs are around about $90 Aussie, which is equivalent to mid-60s US dollars per tonne. So we need to be nimble and we need to be flexible. But as I said, we've endured a downward period in the iron ore price, and certainly this half year so far, or this calendar year, has started very, very strong for us. The iron ore price, you know, picking up to well above $150 US a tonne. Which gives us additional margin from what we previously experienced in the first half.
Yeah, listen, let's talk a quick bit about shares. They've been up and down, but over the last 3 years, really returned quite strongly. What's your take on investor reaction to how you guys at Fenix have been performing?
It's been interesting. I mean, Fenix started in November 2018. We spent the first year drilling our project out and conducting a feasibility study. We spent our second year getting all the permits and native title sorted out, and then we developed the project. So within 2 years, we were in production, and 2 months later, we were shipping our first ore. So it was a meteoric rise. In that time, the iron ore price went from, you know, $100 a tonne to $220 a tonne at that stage. And we were producing, and we quite rightly said we were in cash harvest mode. We were making a lot of money. almost from day dot. So we quickly built up our treasury of cash reserves. We've already paid a fully franked dividend to our shareholders, which amounted to nearly 25 million. I think the market finally woke up to the fact that we were in production and we were making all this cash, and we enjoyed a very meteoric rise. Then, of course, the iron ore price fell away. We're heavily leveraged to the iron ore price, so our shares also fell away. Thankfully, our solid balance sheet meant that we've maintained a cash balance of well above 50 million dollars at the very minimum, and we expect that to build again and get up towards that 100 million mark sometime soon, in the next 6 months, which would be great. Obviously, that's dependent on the iron ore price not collapsing like it did last year, but we're nimble and we're able to adjust our production profile if anything like that happens. So share price is a function of performance. We've performed very solidly. The iron ore price fell away. We were caught up in that. We believe that from here on, the outlook looks promising, and hopefully you'll see that imputed into our share price if we continue to perform like we are.
Yeah, look, it sounds like you're pretty positive. Just give us a recap of what else is on the horizon for you looking ahead to 2022.
Oh, we've been very focused on getting our operation optimized and getting it into production and building the customer base. Now we're starting to look at a bit more business development, a bit more improvement of operations, a bit of capital spend to reduce our operating costs. We've also got a small, well, we've just announced an exploration sort of initiative close to our mine. So hopefully in the next 3 to 6 months, we'll get some drilling happening and maybe be able to expand our resource a little bit, which may then allow us to increase production or increase our mine life. So all going well. We're looking at a very positive next 6 months and hopefully a little bit of growth on the horizon as well.
Good. Well, look, we look forward to hearing more about it when all that comes in.
Great. Thank you. Thank you for your time.
Thanks, Rob.